Welcome to the teaching of the Word of God. I'm so glad that you are seeking God's face and would like to really know His truth and you want to follow God. And God loves you so much. Matthew chapter 24, 45 to 47 says, Who then is a faithful and wise servant whom his master make ruler over his household to give them food in due season? Blessed is that servant whom his master, when he comes, will find so doing. Assuredly, I say to you that he will make him ruler over all his goods. I believe you are that servant of the Almighty God. That's why you want to know the will of your master and you listen to this teaching so that you understand the truth and you understand his will. I believe you shall be promoted, blessed, and lifted up by the Lord as a good servant of God. See you in the teaching. I'm so glad that I can spend time with you to study the Bible together. The Lord told me to teach about the Holy Spirit. And this teaching is in a series called Walk and Live by the Spirit. Let us pray. Father, we thank you so much that you love us and you want to take care of us. You want to guide us by your Holy Spirit. Lord, we thank you, Lord, that you send your Holy Spirit to be in us, on us, and with us all the time, Lord. We want to learn about the Holy Spirit and we want to walk and fellowship with the Holy Spirit, Lord. Thank you, Lord. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. The reason we want to learn about the Holy Spirit is that He is the most important person in our life. We live on this planet Earth, and God the Father is on the throne in heaven. God the Son, the Lord Jesus Christ, is at the right hand of the Father. And the Holy Spirit was sent to us to be in us and on us because we believe in Jesus Christ. He is the best friend, the best helper, the most powerful, all-knowing person. Therefore, as Christians, we should really get to know Him, fellowship with Him, depend on Him, and walk with Him 24/7, all the time. So this teaching helped you to know Him and remind you to really depend on the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit helps us to pray. When we pray, we should depend on the help of the Holy Spirit. He will guide us how to pray, what to pray. If you don't know what to pray, He can pray through us in the angelic language or in tongues. He is the teacher of the Bible. He's the best teacher. Therefore, when I read the Bible, I ask the Holy Spirit to teach me, to show me the truth. I want to be close to the Holy Spirit. I want to really learn how to listen to the witness of the Holy Spirit on the inside of me. And when I teach the Bible, I teach the Word of God, I also ask the anointing of teaching to come upon me. He is the best person that we can fellowship with. When we know the Holy Spirit very well and walk in the Spirit, we will always glorify and magnify Jesus Christ. The Holy Spirit helps us to know the Son of God better and better deep in our spirit. When you get to know somebody, it takes time. It takes some effort to know. Is that right? I know Pastor Da, my wife, now much better than 20 years ago. I know many members of my church now better than a few years ago because I spend time with them, listen to them, and fellowship with them. The Holy Spirit helps us to know the Lord Jesus Christ in a deeper and deeper way. I want to know my Lord. He is my Savior, the Lord Jesus Christ. It's good to love Him, to live for Him. Since I have been touched again and again, repeatedly by the Holy Spirit, I love Jesus more and more than before, and I get to know Him more than before, even though I have never seen Him. But the Spirit of God helped me to know Him. John chapter 15, verse 26, the Bible says, When the Counselor comes, whom I will send to you from the Father, the Spirit of truth, who goes out from the Father, He will testify about me. Me here means Jesus. the Holy Spirit testifies about Jesus. He helps us to know the Son of God, our Savior. John chapter 16, verse 7 and verses 13 to 14. But I tell you the truth. It is for your good that I am going away. Unless I go away, the Counselor will not come to you. But if I go, I will send him to you. The Counselor is the Holy Spirit. But when he, the Spirit of truth, comes, he will guide you into all truth. He will not speak on his own. He will speak only what he hears, and he will tell you what is yet to come. He will bring glory to me. He will bring glory to Jesus, the Son of God, who died for us, who paid a price for us, who shed his blood for us, by taking from what is mine and making it known to you. The Holy Spirit helps us to know the Son of God more and more. He's such a lovely person, gracious, powerful person. The Holy Spirit wants to be our closest and dearest friend. And he brings us closer to the Lord Jesus Christ. Our closest and dearest friend should be the Holy Spirit. Thank God I have one of the most wonderful friends in my life, that is Pastor Da, and many wonderful friends in the New Hope International Church and all over the world. But I consider the Holy Spirit is my dearest friend, and he should be your closest friend as well. The Holy Spirit will supernaturally fill you with his love, that you can love God more and you can love other people more. We cannot depend on our limited human love. We need the love of God. I admit to you that it's not easy to be a pastor. It's not easy to be a preacher like this, especially preaching in English, because English is not my mother tongue language. But the love of God moved in my heart. The love that comes from the Holy Spirit moved in my heart to work so hard, to really try to improve my English accent, to study English, and try to do the best in teaching the Word of God in English. Why? Because the love of God moved in my heart to share the Word of God with English-speaking brothers and sisters. Romans chapter 5, verse 5 say, "And hope does not disappoint us, because God has poured out His love into our hearts by the Holy Spirit, whom He has given us." My brother and sister, we need the love of God in our heart to love Him and to love other people. And the person who poured the love of God into our heart is the Holy Spirit. This is the reason why Satan doesn't want the church to welcome the Holy Spirit or talk about the Holy Spirit or allow the move and the touch of the Holy Spirit to come upon God's people in the church. Because he knows that when the Holy Spirit touches his people, fills his people, the love of God will fill their heart and they will love God even more than before, and they can love one another. Since I welcome the presence of the Holy Spirit, the fire of God, the touch of God in New Hope International Church, I notice that brother and sister in the church don't fight, don't quarrel anymore. They don't have bad attitude toward one another. The church become more lively and full of love because the Holy Spirit has given love to my brother and sister in the church. I need the Holy Spirit. I need more love so I can love even the enemies. I can love unlovely people. I can love people unconditionally. I can love my wife more. I can love my children more. I can love my members more. I can love strangers. My brother and sister, we need the ministry of the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit works hard. He never stops working for us. He never stops helping us. He can help us 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. He gave Peter the interpretation of a vision. He helped Peter in his ministry. If you read the book of Acts carefully, you will find out that the Holy Spirit was totally involved all the time with the ministry of the disciples and the apostle in the book of Acts. Acts chapter 10, 19 to 20. Why Peter was still thinking about the vision, the Spirit said to him, "Simon, three men are looking for you. So get up and go downstairs. Do not hesitate to go with them, for I have sent them." The Holy Spirit spoke to Peter that Cornelius sent his men to invite Peter to come to his home to hear the gospel. You see, the Holy Spirit helped Peter. How much more we need the Holy Spirit? When Peter was preaching the word of God in the house of Cornelius, the Holy Spirit showed up, helped him again. Acts chapter 10, 44 to 46. While Peter was still speaking these words, the Holy Spirit came on all who heard the message. The circumcised believers who had come with Peter were astonished that the gift of the Holy Spirit had been poured out even on the Gentiles, for they heard them speaking in tongues and praising God. Then Peter said, my brother, sister, the Holy Spirit works hard. He helps us all the time. When we serve God, we need to depend on the Holy Spirit all the time. Humble ourselves and depend on the Holy Spirit all the time in our work, in our family life, in our ministry. We should always recognize the help, the grace, the power, and the grace of the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit is an active person. He never stopped working. When Peter preached the word of God, the gospel or the word, the Holy Spirit shows up. The word of God is the foundation for everything. My brother and sister, even though I love the presence of the Holy Spirit, the move of the Holy Spirit, I always stick with the word of God, because the Holy Spirit will not do anything against or opposite to the word of God. That's why I always read the word of God when I preach the word of God. When I preach the sermon, I always read the word. And I want to really depend on the Holy Spirit by really coming to the word of God first. And then the Holy Spirit will do his work, because he supports the word. We need both the word 100% and the Holy Spirit 100%. The Holy Spirit knows what is happening in his servant's life, and he has great concern for his servants, you and me. He knows about the future. He knows that the accident gonna happen over there. Don't drive there. He knows that don't invest money with this guy. He gonna cheat you. He is all-knowing, and he has great concern for our well-being. This is why we should be led by the Holy Spirit. Acts chapter 11, 27 to 29. During this time, some prophets came down from Jerusalem to Antioch. One of them, named Agabus, stood up and threw, wow, the book of Acts talks about the Holy Spirit a lot. Through the Spirit, not through his own flesh, not through his own observation, not through his own intellectual ability. Through the Spirit, predicted that a severe famine would spread over the entire Roman world. This happened during the reign of Claudius. The disciple, each according to his ability, decided to provide help for the brothers living in Judea. You see, the Holy Spirit know that famine will happen, and he talked through the prophet and encouraged the brothers to help people who live in Judea. You see, the Holy Spirit works all the time. He knows everything. Therefore, I would like to encourage you to be filled with the Holy Spirit, to walk with the Spirit, to surrender and yield to the power, to the wisdom and the leading of the Holy Spirit. He will guide you. He will work with you. He will work through you to bless other people. He may use you to prophesy. He may use other people to tell you what's going to happen in the future. He will tell you directly, don't go there, an accident will happen. Don't invest there. Don't get involved with this group of people. Don't associate with this group of people. Go to that church. Learn from that pastor. Don't listen to the sermon from this group of people or from this church, because the teaching are not biblical. He will tell you. He will guide you. He cares for you. He cares for your well-being. So please get to know the Holy Spirit more. I would like to encourage you to listen to all the teaching in this series, Walk and Live in the Spirit, again and again many times, and develop your relationship with the Holy Spirit. I know that my teaching is very simple, but it's good to listen again and again to build faith, to increase revelation and understanding, and so that we can experience what the Word of God say. God bless you. I will see you in other teaching in this series. God loves you so much, and may the Lord anoint you, fill you, guide you, and give you grace and help you to know the Holy Spirit in a deeper and greater way as time goes by. In Jesus' name. Thank you so much. God bless you. Thank you so much for listening to this teaching. I'm so glad that you are seeking the Lord, and I pray that He will give you strength, grace, mercy, love, wisdom to be able to be successful in your life, and you shall receive the blessing of Abraham, and you shall be the blessing to many people around you. Remember this, the Bible promises in the book of Philippians chapter 4 verse 13, I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. Therefore, I believe that the Holy Spirit will strengthen you to be able to do what you learn from the scripture, and you shall rise up higher and higher like an eagle, and you shall overcome all the problems in your life, and God will get the glory through you. Thank you so much. I will see you next time in the next teaching. God bless you.
The Heavenly Father loves you so much. He wants to bless you, anoint you, and use you to be the blessing to the nations. May He put His hand upon you and give you so much grace, so much strength, joy, and wisdom. May the fire of God come and burn on the inside of you and use you to touch many lives in the world. May heaven be open over you and pour the goodness of God, the blessing of the Lord into your life. May God use you to carry the fire to other people. Set the captive free, heal the sick, preach the gospel, and make disciples. Build His kingdom. May the grace of God work in your life, and you become fruitful, and you will have many rewards in heaven. May the Lord get the glory through you.